In our other recovery videos, we've shown you how to hook up for full flow and make sure that you're able to pull the refrigerant out of the system and get it into the cylinder quickly. But what's really important is making sure that it stays fast once you get recovery. Now you've got full flow going to the tank, make sure you're hooked up to the vapor port. It's open straight to the top of the tank, as opposed to the liquid port, which uses a 1/4-inch dip tube going all the way to the bottom. That's a huge restriction that you just don't need. But since you're going to be pulling the liquid out of the system first in an ideal process, you want to fill that liquid from the bottom up. How do we do that? We flip the tank. I'm going to open up the tank, which is going to suck in a little bit of the refrigerant from the hose that I've already purged out. When flipping the tank, make sure you rotate it in a direction that will tighten the fitting. You want to make sure that you're not loosening the fitting and possibly getting refrigerant in your face, as fun as that might be. So now we've got the tank upside down. We're ready to start once we open all the valves and get things moving. We'll start by opening the liquid port from the system, making sure that's fully ready to go. And just before we start the recovery, we're going to open the valves. Everything's ready to go. It should begin flowing to the tank automatically. You'll make sure that you've teared your refrigerant scale so you can monitor the whole process. Now, it's time to begin recovering. So you notice that while we're moving refrigerant pretty quick, I've already moved 2 pounds in just a few seconds. The machine is not noisy. That's because we've removed all the restrictions. Now, as you get the liquid out of the system, pretty soon you're going to have vapor. That's the point at which refrigerant recovery starts heating up the tank, at least a little bit. You can do a number of things, such as getting an ice bucket, throwing a wet towel and blowing a fan on it, but you know what's really easy? Just grab the G5 and blow its fan. You can obviously have that sit on a stool or something, and have that fan pull air around the cylinder. That helps dissipate a lot of extra heat over just ambient air. However, overall, because we've taken this process and opened it up, the tank's going to stay a lot cooler than you might expect. Now, as you're watching your gauges, you've started with the liquid side, and at a certain point, depending on the size of the system, you're going to open up the vapor port. This allows you to pull from both sides of the system at the same time to fully complete the process. When recovering with the method where you turn the recovery cylinder upside down, you got to understand when to turn it back. And that's because you want to make sure that the hose coming from the recovery machine to the cylinder is filled only with vapor. Keep in mind, a recovery machine can only push refrigerant as far as the top of its piston, so there will always be some amount of refrigerant in this output hose. Ideally, that's vapor, so it has lower density, and that greatly reduces any refrigerant lost in the process. So you'll be watching for the pressures to be between 75 and 100 PSI on your input side before rotating the tank. You can also use a sight glass to be sure that liquid is fully done, because your idea, again, is to make sure it's only vapor. When you rotate the tank back to the right side up, make sure, again, that you rotate in a direction that would tighten the fitting. Again, this is for safety. You do not want those fittings coming loose during the process. The recovery process is complete when you have pulled the system down to the required EPA level of either 10 or 15 inches of mercury, depending on the size and type of system and refrigerant. In this case, we're already at 12 inches of mercury. We've moved 10 pounds of refrigerant in just a matter of minutes by opening up the flow and making sure that the process can go smoothly. The tank has stayed cool, pressures have stayed low. Now, to shut off the recovery machine, you'll first make sure you have valved off the valves of the system, watching all the gauges to show that you have pulled a nice deep vacuum on your input line. And then you'll want to make sure that you have shut your output valve at the same time as you turn off the machine. This is to make sure you don't have any significant back pressure from the tank pushing refrigerant back up to the hoses. And by quickly shutting all the valves involved, you're making sure you have the minimum amount of refrigerant in the hose to meet EPA de minimis requirements, but your recovery's done. Try these tips out on your next recovery job. We hope you'll find that it'll make fast refrigerant recovery easy. Send us your feedback and comments about your experiences in the field, as well as what other videos you'd like to see. From everyone at Appion, thanks for watching.